So hello everyone, welcome to my show 12 in 10, and today we have Sonal Sehgal. Everybody knows about her. She is gorgeous, beautiful and very talented actor, but very few know that she is also a writer and lyricist. So welcome to BDC or in my show, Sonal.
Thank you for having me. Very few people know this, that I actually started out as a writer. I used to work as a copywriter in an advertising agency. Even before I became an actor, I was a writer. So you know, if you're once a writer, and writing stories and poems is something I've been doing since I was a teenager. So it's nothing, you know, it was something that just never leaves you. And as an actor, you have so much downtime. In between movies, and for any actor, you know, you never do, even if you do three movies in a year, you know, that's what, 3 months of work? And then you have so much time in between, most actors I know spend that in between time in gyms, you know, and I spend that time writing. And I used to always write poems, and then when I met my husband, who's a musician, I started writing songs for him. So it was just like, you know, if you're both sitting at home, and you know, similarly, even musicians have a lot of downtime. So there would be weeks of no work, and
of course,
just both of us at home. So we would make songs. You know, it's better than killing each other. So.
Which we are doing in this pandemic.
So we are very good at working together.
Wonderful.
And it all kind of, you know, just works out. If I'm not acting, I'm writing. Last year, I produced a film. Actually, we finished shooting January of this year, before.
Wonderful. Otherwise, everybody were sitting at home and waiting to start, you know, shooting and things.
Lucky. So we were very, very lucky. So this was with my friend from film school. She's a Latvian girl. That's it. No, it's not a Hindi film. It's an English film.
Oh, wonderful.
We were together in New York. We were studying in film school in New York. And so that's how we go back a long way. And, you know, over the years, we've been trying to work together, but nothing ever happens. And last year, it just so happened that I had written the script and she loved it. And she thought, like, you know, it has to fit her sensibilities also, because we're completely different cultures.
Absolutely.
You know? Yeah. So for a foreign director to direct a script written by an Indian, So we did that. And actually, when the pandemic started, the edit started. So it worked out very well for us. Initially, of course, I panicked, you know, but it worked out very well for us, because now everybody was just locked in their houses. You know, nobody has any excuses. So work just happens faster.
It is.
Editing is something you can do online, you know.
Of course.
So, you know, the editor would edit few scenes, he would send it to her, he would send it to me, we would get back. So it kept us very occupied. So we had no time actually to get bored or whatever.
Because, you know, in this pandemic, or stayed at home, but I see that everybody became a cook.
Yeah.
And everybody is in the kitchen or gym or in front of camera. You know, because everybody is free. So they said, okay, fine, theek hai, hum interview karte. So mujhe isme itne sare interviews mil gaye, almost more than 25 interviews I did.
Wow.
I don't have time to get bored. But anyway, Sonal, your career in film started with Nagesh Kukunur and John Ibrahim. correct?
Right.
So
right.
How did it happen?
So, you know, I actually, before that I had done two TV shows. There was Sara Akash, which was a show based on the Indian Air Force, and then there was Hotel Kingston. And both the shows, I was the lead, and they were like on prime time television. But I auditioned for Nagesh's film. So, you know, it's like the whole nepotism debate that we have. Like, you know, if you are an outsider, you might have two hit TV shows, but you still don't get a movie till you audition. But I kind of like that because, you know, I earned it.
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
So I auditioned with, like, I don't know, thousands of girls for that film.
Wow.
And I was just lucky. I was just so lucky because I had been such a huge Nagesh Kuknur fan, you know, from the time he made Hyderabad Blues.
Yeah.
It was just like, you know, I remember my manager calling me that saying, you know, there is this film and there, but then you will have to audition. I was like, I'll do it. Yeah. I'll audition. I have no problems.
Of course.
You know,
so procedure is okay. As soon as you have not faced that, you know, the nepotism or things like that, it's not, if it is real, why not?
Absolutely.
So you got the films.
Yes.
So how was your experience with you know, John Ibrahim and Nageshwar?
Both are absolutely amazing. Nagesh is an fantastic, fantastic director. I mean, there is just no compromise with him. You know, if he needs a perfect shot, it's going to be a perfect shot. You know, no matter how much time it takes, how many takes it takes. So he's very, very good. John, again, you know, I mean, I was just, John was already a star when I was a complete newcomer.
Yep.
You know, so, but his discipline, his dedication to work, like he would always, if like the call time was say 7 a.m., John would be there at 6:55.
Wow, really?
You know, and I was running.
No stardom.
No stardom. And I would always, you know how girls are, like, my hair is not done, my shoes are in my hand, and I'm running there, like, trying to somehow make it to 7 a.m. But he's always there before me.
Wow. You have two best films in your account, Mantostan and Lihaf. And both films based on the best writers of Urdu literature, Manto and Smith.
Yes.
So these are the roles one can wish to do.
I know.
How do you get this?
Yeah, so you know, I like you said, I am truly blessed to have played characters written by Manto and then Ismat.
Ismat, see. You know?
So I remember when Rahat first came to me for Mantostan, I did not really know him. I had worked with another friend of his on another film, and I think I just met him a couple of times. He had come on the set or something, but not, I mean, we weren't friends, we didn't know each other. So one day he messaged me and said, like, you know, I'd like to meet you about this new film. So I was like, okay,
Mantostan.
And Mantostan. And he just said that, you know, I'm making this film, it's about four short stories written about written by Manto. And I was just like, yes. He's like, sunto lo kaun sa kahani hai? I said, nahin, yes.
Yeah.
Koi bhi kahani hai. Manto ka koi bhi kahani hai.
Of course, Kulwant Kaur is his very typical but very, very intense role of that situation. औरत का जो औरत को जो सफर करना पड़ा है वो सबसे ज्यादा Kulwant Kaur is a symbol of that women.
Yeah.
So tell me about when you're doing as a woman, what were your feelings?
Yeah. So, you know, I thought Kulwant Kaur was also, I think, way ahead of her time. You know, she was very independent and feisty. Yes, she was insecure, you know, but us time pe kisi ka mistress ban ke rehna, wo kisi ki, wo biwi ban ke, matlab wo, you know, us वो जो हमारे इंडियन सोसाइटी में वो जो बीवी होता है कि हमेशा दबे रहना मर्द से, जूती के नीचे रहना, she could have been that to someone also. She could have been, you know.
Of course.
But no, she was a mistress, which, you know, a mistress, yeah, socially it's looked down upon, but at the same time, I think there is a sense of freedom.
Yeah.
That comes with it, that, you know, I run my own house, I run my own life, nobody is the boss of mine. So, yes, while she is very insecure when Ishar Singh goes missing and she loses her mind, but at the same time, she's, you know, while I just felt like it was like, while the country was fighting for its freedom, Kalwant Kaur was also fighting for her own freedom from social clutches, you know. And she would not stand for being trampled upon. So the fact that Ishar cheated on her, she would not forgive that.
No.
She would not say, that's what I'm saying. She was very forward. She was like a very emancipated woman, that she would be like, abhi to yehi hai mere paas. I know women in today's day and age who would forgive their husbands or infidelities, because ab kya, this guy provides for me, I have to, you know,
live with him. There is even now.
Yeah.
The feminist character he wrote, you know, way back, just not a writer, he or she, Ismat, I mean, see, aap lehaf ho aur sab dekho, it's okay if you are not with me.
Yeah.
I can find my way to go, or, you know, whatever, you know. So, yeah. And I'm so happy that lehaf is getting so many awards from festivals. Including my festival too.
Yes, yes.
I'm so happy with that. It's a beautiful movie, and your role, amazing, and looks so pretty.
So the
reaction you get from the audience on the both film, what was that?
And you know, the good part is that wherever we've screened Manto and Lihaz, Mantostan and Lihaz, almost all over the world by now, and I'm surprised. Like in London, I'm talking about white British people. In Germany, again, I'm talking about white British people. They seem to have all read the stories before. You know, these are, of course, a lot of literature students, you know, who came to watch. And then, you know, the kind of discussions we had in the Q&A were just fantastic. You know, and I was just so, so happy that, you know, actually you feel proud, like, you know, our country's literary works are still being read all over the world. And then that kind of makes you nervous as an actor, because you're like, oh my God, these people already know. Yeah. So I hope I did justice to the character.
Yes, of course. Know? And I saw you first in Gajini. No.
Gajini,
And this is so pretty. But, you know, pretty face, everyone can remember. Yes, and she is very pretty. I have to talk about her. But after Mantostan and Lehaf, I am a big fan of yours.
Thank you so much.
What is the best piece advice you have received after both movies?
What is the best advice I have received? I can't really think of
anything. I became a big fan of you.
I think that's the biggest one that you're saying, you became my fan.
So, it just came in my mind suddenly. You did a commercial film, you did art film.
Yeah.
Do you think art film, jo identity hai aapki personal as a Sonal Sehgal, Begum Jaan ke baad wo kuch hurt hoti hai ya kuch push ho jati hai on the back aur Begum Jaan ka character aage aa gaya, kuch aisa hota hai? there is a misconception के ये जो है वो commercial art actor है, ये art actor है, you know. तो
what is
the difference you to think?
I think अभी तो काफी change हो रहा है. You know, the audience is also understanding. There is a kind of like middle ground now. It's not like, oh, you're an art house actress, now you only do art house films, and you you know, you're a commercial actor, so you only do that. But I think when you so even a lot of commercial films are now kind of, you know, coming
coming back in you know, commercial.
Yeah, they suddenly they're realizing how important the story is.
So let's move on. What's your favorite thing in your closet right now?
Shorts and t-shirts.
Do you have pets?
No, I used to have a pet in Delhi when I grew up, where I grew up with my parents. But you know, because I grew up with pets, and I know how much space they need, you know, like dogs to run around. So which is why I always thought that it's unfair to keep them in a Bombay in a two bedroom apartment. It's just not fair, you know. But yeah, like a few years ago, my dog died, and then my parents were like they didn't want to keep another pet. My mother's words were, "हम अपने बच्चों को अपने से पहले मरता नहीं देख सकते, you know."
हाँ. So tell me about your favorite movie, all time favorite.
My all time favorite movie would be Life is Beautiful.
Life is Beautiful. I love it too.
I like
it. This is so fun movie. Yeah.
Or and like, and Bollywood would be Jaane Bhi Do Yaaru. You know,
I just love it. I just love that movie.
And you know, and as you grow older, you realize, like, you know, when you watched it, when you know, when you were a kid, you just laughed. It was just a laugh riot.
Yes.
Yeah. But when you grow older, you realize, you watch it again and again, you realize it was such a strong political satire. Or at the time, really, you know.
Yeah.
It had so many layers. So, you know, it's like, it is just a masterpiece. I think till today, India hasn't made a movie like to beat that one.
Yeah.
You know, because it's not just stupid slapstick comedy. It has layers. It is a satirical, slap on the system. On the
journalism on the system, yeah.
You know? So on so many levels, it's just so, and of course the actors, oh my God.
All fine actors were there.
Yeah.
Ina Gupta, Satish Shah, Nasruddin Shah.
Satish Kaushik.
Satish Kaushik.
Kaushik.
All beautiful, beautiful.
Ravi Vaswani.
I forgot his name, so I, please send me, I forgot the name of him. He told me back, he says Ravi Vaswani. It's beautiful film. So, Sonal, describe yourself as a teenager in 3 words.
As a teenager, I was just a dreamer.
Dreamer.
I was a big dreamer.
Big dreamer.
A voracious reader. You know, how much I used to finish one novel in one day.
Like
Hardy Boys or a Nancy Drew. So my dad had got me admission to this Delhi public library. And every day on his way back from office, he would bring me one novel.
Wonderful.
And I would sit up the whole night. So padhai wadhai to gai. Kahan pe? So like as a dreamer, reader, and three things you said, right?
Yes. One more thing.
Dreamer, reader, and I would still say a writer. And then, you know what I used to do? When the novel used to finish, I used to write down what would have happened after that.
Interesting, because you are a writer now. You want to write.
Because I just couldn't be like, how has this ended? Like, in my head, it has not ended.
Yeah, of course. Of course.
Yeah.
Because you are a writer. I mean, there is a writer in you, no? So you have to say something about it, whatever happening around you. That's wonderful. Yeah. Tell me what are you carrying in your bag every day when you go outside?
Sunglasses.
Of course. Cell phone.
Mobile phone.
It's a common thing. Something special.
Something special. Oh, you know what? I carry these oil blotting papers. My skin is so oily.
Oh, wonderful.
And everybody keeps telling me that it's a good thing. They're like, it's a good thing.
It's a good thing. It's really good thing. But you know what? I heard somewhere in some interviews is Deepika Padukone says, I always carrying sui dhaga. And why you are carrying sui dhaga?
Yeah, for what?
So something happened, so I can stitch. So anything, something like that, you have it in your bag.
No. And this ointment called calendula.
Okay.
It's a homeopathic ointment. So, you know, my skin is so sensitive. It's like, you know, if I wear a mask and go out for 1 hour, I get like rashes. So I just put like, And I recommend that. It's almost like I'm sounding like I'm selling this cream online right now. it's like $50.
Really?
And it's like a big pot of $50. And it's magic. Wonderful. You know, it's like your skin breaks out, you put a little bit and you're good to go.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful.
It's a homeopathic medicine.
Okay. So as the pandemic is still going on, and we do not have much to do except eating, cooking, watching TV. Ab to filmein baaki nahi rahi hain, sari dekh rahi hain. So tell me what interesting you did in the last 4 or 5 months.
Okay, so you know, I think viewers abroad are, but I think Indian viewers abroad are going to understand this, that you know, in India, we all have house help, right?
Yeah.
It's, you don't have to be rich to have someone to cook and clean for you.
You are rich, I know that.
a lot of my foreign friends don't understand this.
No.
So when the pandemic hit, I'm telling you, it's the first time in my life I think I have done housework. I mean, of course, you know, we divided it between me and my husband, but still it is a lot of work,
of course,
you know.
Of course, entire house.
Clean, 3 times a day you have to make food. And like I said, I'm not a good cook. And my husband is worse. So we're quite the couple. So I think that's why we lost weight, because you can hardly eat the food that I make, you know. Yeah. So you're only going to eat as much as
food. How was your childhood? मैं ये पहला क्वेश्चन होना चाहिए था, लेकिन अब कर रही हूँ क्योंकि यू नो चाइल्डहुड विल टेल द स्टोरी ऑफ वन्स लाइफ.
यस यस या
तो मैं आपकी स्टोरी पहले सुनना चाहती थी, तब मैंने कहा कि अब पूछूंगी योर चाइल्डहुड.
सो आई हैड अ वेरी रेगुलर चाइल्डहुड. Just after I was born, my parents lived in Delhi, so I grew up there. Yeah. And I have an elder sister, and my parents tell me that, you know, and she's much older than me. So when I was born, she was already going to school.
Oh,
okay. So it used to be like my parents would, and like when I was 2 years old, it's like, I used to insist that I want to go to school, because she went to school and she looked like she was having fun. So every day, it's like after she would leave for school, I also had like my little bag, and I would go out the one door. You know, in Delhi, you have big houses and you have back door in front. Yes. So I would go out the back door, come in from the front door.
So kuch yaad hai Delhi ki? कुछ खाना, हाँ, so, कुछ पीना, कुछ
खाना तो, या दिल्ली का खाना तो आई थिंक दैट्स व्हाई And you know, my mother is a fantastic cook.
Oh, wonderful.
So I think that's why I can never like my cooking or anyone else's cooking, because, you know, everybody has to compare to my mother. So
absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah. And yeah, Delhi mein, I remember in college, we used to go to this Chola Bhatura place. Oh my God. Mm-hmm. In Delhi University, I said, in North Campus, and every day almost we would have this Chola Bhatura. And I keep telling my trainer now that I was like, you know what? I used to be 48 kilos with 5'8" height, and I used to have Chola Bhaturas every day. Mm-hmm. So all your diet and all that is, I don't understand.
Tell me about your film. You said that it's completed in this Jan. So
yes.
Where it will go and where people will see that?
Okay, so this is a sci-fi thriller. No, this is science fiction. This is science fiction and a psychological thriller. Okay, so it's a Indo-Latvian co-production, and the lead guy, he's Russian. So yeah, so we have a British actor. We like the main character. One is British, one is Russian. There's another girl in the film. She's Latvian. She's a very big Latvian TV actress. This Russian guy is a very big actor. He's just done a series with Sophie Turner,
mm-hmm,
Game of Thrones.
Yep.
Okay, Sophie Turner. So yeah, he's just done a series with her. So yeah, so we've taken like a pretty good cast from different countries, because you know it's a subject which is, you know, which any, you don't have to be from a certain culture to understand.
Yeah, of course.
So yeah, so now we're going to start pitching it to platforms. Or festivals. I don't know how many are actually happening now. I'm guessing.
In America, Canada, all film festival go virtual. So will be in October, early October or mid-October.
Okay.
It will be virtual too.
Oh, okay. So we're just talking to some OTT platforms. You know, we've just started talking actually.
Wonderful.
So let's see. Yeah, where it goes.
Good luck for that.
Thank you.
So, बहुत अच्छा लगा. Would you like to say something about your audience?
I would just like to tell everybody, stay safe, stay healthy. Let us all collectively pray that this goddamn coronavirus just dies. I think because we are humans and we need human touch, human connection. You know, I mean, it's great to catch up like this virtually, but you know, I think we need to see real people and hang out with real people. So, yeah.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.